separation side.
Have you ever been asked to consult with the FBI?
Yes, I've worked on some projects with them.
Okay. And have they ever funded any of your research?
Yes, they have.
Okay. And have you also been a reviewer for peer-reviewed journals?
Yes.
For which organizations?
A variety, the Journal of Chromatographic Science, the Journal of Forensic Science, Forensic Science International, many, many journals.
Doctor, I'd like to get down to why we called you here today.
Okay.
Have you ever done any research dealing with odor signatures? And
yes,
if so,
I have.
Which kind? Can you tell the court a little bit about that?
Yes. So most of my work over about the last 20 years has focused on looking at the odor signatures above forensic specimens with a mind towards trying to understand how dogs are able to locate forensic specimens, and then with a mind towards making better machines in the future to complement what the capabilities are of the canines. So it's my initial work focused on drugs, and more recently I've done accelerants, explosives, live humans, and human remains.
Okay. And what materials were you given to review in this case?
A variety of police reports related to the case, autopsy reports, photographs, the preliminary and the final reports from Oak Ridge National Lab, from ARPOD, Voss, and co-workers, and let's see, what else? And then I did literature search and read the most recent relevant literature. So.
Were you also able to review depositions of any key parties?
Yes, I read the depositions of the all of the Oak Ridge team, the FBI chemist, and the canine handler.
Okay. And in after reviewing any of these, all of those materials, did you offer a report?
Yes, I did.
Okay. And we've submitted that. You submitted that to all parties, correct?
Yes, I have.
Okay. What professional organizations do you belong to?
I'm a member of the American Chemical Society, past president of the South Florida section, and I'm a fellow of the American Academy of Forensic Sciences.
Why does a professional like yourself belong to these organizations?
It's important for a variety of reasons. One is attending the regular attendance of the national meetings, and members get a certain discounts and benefits as members. The networking part is important because you usually network with other members of the profession. And there are certain codes of ethics that you need to follow in order to maintain your membership.
And based on these codes of ethics, do these organizations also police their members, so to speak, by ensuring that they follow these codes of ethics?
Yes.
Okay. Are you aware if ARPOD Voss is a member of any
relevancy?
Well, it goes to the credibility of the witness that the state has put forth, Judge.
And I cannot use another expert to do that, Mr. Baez.
Very well, Judge.
Objection sustained.
Now, the research dealing with odor signature analysis of human remains. Have you read all of the relevant papers on that topic?
I believe so, at least all the ones that I'm aware of.
Okay. And in fact, have you published any?
Yes, I have.
Okay. And when did you publish your first paper on this topic?
I have one peer-reviewed paper, which came out in 2003. And I have a master's student who published her thesis and a PhD student who published her dissertation. And from that PhD student's dissertation, we have one paper submitted and another paper in preparation, but those are not published yet.
Okay. Were you the first one to write a paper on the odor signature dealing with human remains?
I'm not sure if I was the first one, but I know it was probably one of the, you know, one of the early researchers in this area.
Okay. And do all of these different papers and studies that have been done, do they all agree?
No. There's actually wide disagreement amongst the different studies that have been completed. There's some agreement in some areas, but a large amount of inconsistencies.
So would you testify to this court that the odor signatures of human decomposition is generally accepted in the scientific community?
No.
And have you prepared any exhibits to assist the court in trying to show the differences of the different papers and studies that have been done?
Yes, I put together a table of all of the published studies that I'm aware of in terms of the VOCs to try to look at the common volatile organic compounds.
We have just discovery violations. We approach.
You may. We'll take a 5-minute recess.